something that, you know, holds or bars you from, you know, participating. You have undertaken to familiarize yourself with its context. You have accepted and agreed that if you are accused of any activity that may interfere with the ordinary function of the university, you may be subject to immediate suspension from participation in university activities and excluded from the university campus pending the investigation or the completion, rather, of the disciplinary proceedings, if any which may be instituted against you. You have agreed and accepted. Blah 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 blah. But basically, this was, you know, what we had to sign, and it, you know, played a role in, you know, further silencing students at, you know, on our campus. You know, people after the RE reference list into 2017, it's really been hard to, you know, kind of continue that conversation because it's not like it's the end. It, you know, it out. The list continues. The narrative. You know, persists. It's still there. The issue is still there. But you know, Rhodes has managed to instill that fear, you know, onto its student body. That, you know, if you were to try kind of embark on any sort of radical transformation of sorts, then, you know, you will be on immediate effect, you know, be suspended, which has been the case with, you know, some of the excluded students at the university. Not just myself, you know, one lady, she found out that she had she would be charged with kidnapping as well, outside of just, you know, myself and, you know, the other three women throughout these proceedings. She, upon registration, found out that she will be, 2 days after registering, going to classes. She had an appeal regarding, you know, academic purposes, but it was successful. She was a registered student. You know, within a few days of attending lectures as a registered student in 2017, she, you know, finds out that, you know, she's going to be charged, she is charged with kidnapping, assault, and insubordination, and that, you know, there will be a disciplinary hearing, you know, against her. She obviously withdrew at the university, but she was quite, you know, intricately involved with the internet. You know, she's been involved as well as an activist. It has been an emotionally taxing experience. She had nothing to do with, you know, the university. And so she got a transcript, and the transcript then again was endorsed with these disciplinary pending, and then with the charges, even though she, you know, has been, she has withdrew from the institution. And yeah, so I don't know, it's just really, Rhodes has been on an agenda of sorts.
Wanted to comment on the second question?
I mean, there's a reason why it's called the Rhodes War, because essentially Rhodes University and various other institutions have declared war on black women and black women's bodies, and other intersectional bodies as well, across campuses. And the only way to respond to a war is to fight back. And the only way for a war to end is essentially for there to be a victor. And in this instance, not only as Black Women's Caucus, but as black bodies, as intersectional bodies across the country, we will make sure that we are the victors at the end of the day. Because we're going to make sure that with, you know, the help of SERI and our business norms, are going to do it legally. I know every time I say something, people are just like, hey. But to do it legally, but to make sure that, as I've mentioned earlier, that we get the adequate and right response and, you know, the lawful response to this, and essentially to make sure that, you know, our comrades are acquitted of these charges that the university cannot prove, and we know they cannot prove because they are innocent. So as we said earlier on, unless the university can prove, you know, with tangible evidence and without a reasonable doubt, that our comrades are guilty, we're going to work on the not only the presumption but the facts that they are innocent, and we will respond as we should, with the same militancy as we are faced with from these institutions. And since they're going the legal route, we've got SERI or Sisnomzamo, and we will take it further from there.
Thank you.